Callie, making you a quick video for single leg deadlift. The single leg deadlift looks like an easy movement pattern, but it's very complicated because it does so much good for the lower body, specifically the ankle, knee, and hip stabilization. When you do this properly, you will gain strength in your lower body, stabilization that occurs throughout your lower body from the feet to your hips. And it also still involves lat control, abs, and stabilization upper body as well. There are a couple of modifications that you can do with this. There are also variations to a single leg deadlift. So the one I'm focusing on today is contralateral single leg deadlift. What that means is you're holding the bell or weight, it can be a dumbbell, opposite the working leg. When we do things contralaterally, we are basically working in opposition. So our body is like an X. And when we move in opposition like that, it engages our vestibular system. Our vestibular system is located in our inner ear. And what that does is recruit the vestibular system in opposition, moving in opposition, which fires the vestibular system and improves coordination, balance, and spatial awareness. So, what you want to do, if this is all brand new to you, you may have to use support when you do this. So today for the video, I'm going to basically use the wall as support to show you that variation. But you could also use something like a weight rack, if you're training at home, a door facing, even a cabinet that's low enough for you to do your single leg deadlift with a little bit of support. So when we do the single leg deadlift, I like to teach beginners to start from standing. What I'm going to do is I'm going to grab the kettlebell, stand in position, and get very tight. If you're not tight at the bottom of your single leg deadlift, you're not going to do it correctly. So what you want to do is get tight, abs contracting, glutes contracting. I'm standing right now on my left leg, which is my working leg, and I'm holding the bell contralaterally in my right hand. What's going to happen is I'm going to flex through my right foot and sit back, folding at the hip again, into my left leg, and come up. When I do this, the left leg is the working leg, the right leg is staying contracted in the air, low. When I get comfortable with this, you're gonna see that the kettlebell actually hits the floor. And then I pull up. When I do that correctly, there's a huge load on this left glute. You can see I lost my balance there. Let me show you support using the wall here. When you use support, you wanna be standing close to the support of your working leg. So in this case, I'm gonna stand on my right leg, use the wall as needed, and hold the kettlebell in my left arm. When I go left leg, I'll turn so that I'm beside the working leg. Make sense? So here I am. I'm going to pick the kettlebell up, bring my arm down low on the support so that when I go back into my single leg deadlift, I won't have a tendency to raise my shoulders. You want to keep your shoulders packed, your back nice and flat, that leg that's in the air, press through the heel straight, and sit back. Single leg deadlift can be very frustrating at first. Have to take it slow, methodical. It's very taxing on the nervous system. And you'll find, as crazy as it is, you'll be out of breath when you do it right.